Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, my name is Cheyenne. This is my channel, Life with Cheyenne, where I talk about everything faith and lifestyle. Today I want to share with you five things I wish I knew and I want you to know before you become a flight attendant. If you want to see that and you want to hear more about what those thoughts are, continue watching. So, five things I want to share about what you should know before you become a flight attendant. These are things that I have learned over the course of my almost 5 months of flying. As you know, if you can go back in my channel, I became a flight attendant going into my fifth month, and it has just been just the most incredible experience. However, being a flight attendant, like me, many persons see it as an ideal job, and in a lot of ways it is. It has truly been amazing, but it has not been without its challenges. And when some of them came, it was very hard for me because, as I said, you see it as this idealistic, glamorous job, pop pop pop, but you don't think about like the challenges that you will face. So, and just these are things I wish I knew, so I want to share with you what I wish someone told me before they pinned on those wings. Thank you guys. Also, I want to say thank you for getting to it. Thank you for rocking with me. Thank you for all the love on the Cure Stuff vlog. I'm really trying to do a video every week, guys. But this flight attendant life, I'm literally on my layover now. I literally got up this morning at 3 o'clock. My first flight was after 5, and then we got in. I'm not so tired, so I said, okay, I'm gonna do the vlog because we do a vlog, and then then I'm gonna go ahead and post it because, yeah. So, I'm so tired, but I'm still committed to this channel. This is like my fun thing that I like to do, so I'm doing it, right? Yes, so. What are five things that I wish I knew before I became a flight attendant that I want you to know if you have plans or, you know, have dreams of becoming a flight attendant? All right. So the first one is you are going to be very tired. That was a shocker for me. And I don't know why it was. Because think about it, guys. When you fly like one flight, you are tired. Some people, it takes days for them to recover. And as a flight attendant, you can do up. Some days we do one flight, but a lot of days we don't do one flight. Today we did like 2 flights. Some days you can do up to 4 flights. And even if those flights are not long, if we end up doing 4 flights, they're shorter flights. But then you have to deplane, board again, change gates, delays, all of those stuff. And you're doing that back to back to back to back. As a new flight attendant, I pick up trips like on my off days and stuff. So I end up flying on my work days and on my off days. So I do end up flying a lot. And it really catches up to you. Also, I do not live like near to the airport. So it takes me by train 2 hours to get to the airport. If I'm driving or if I'm driven by my husband, it's an hour 15 hour 10, so I'm not close to the airport, so I have to factor in all of those, and they add up over time, and you're gonna be so tired. The thing is though, because I started flying a lot in February, and then I remember when it really hit me, I remember literally crying because I was like, oh my gosh. And then I had to keep going to the airport, coming back home, because for some reason I had a bunch of turns. And I remember one night as I lay down in my bed, I felt like I was having an outer body experience, like my body was levitating. It was so crazy. Like I was like, I don't know. I literally don't know. I remember one time I was on a plane 12 days straight. 12 consecutive days I was on a plane. But I did it. And then I found out over time how to work around it. So it has not been so bad. I started to take vitamins. I started to take supplements. So that as well. I ensure that I sleep. I do not care where the crew is going. If we get somewhere, I'm going to my bed. Because you have to be alert. You have to be up as a flight attendant. This is not a job that gives to grogginess and slouchiness. And I hate how I feel when I don't get a lot of sleep. So I make sure that I sleep and stuff. But you're gonna be tired. And no, you still feel it not like as bad. But for me, not as bad, because you're kind of working around the details of it, the routine. Your body start realizing and, you know, like that. But you are going to be tired. Those flights, the jet setting, the flying here and there and everywhere, it's gonna get to you. And then sometimes you're like literally all over the place. Like some days you do, if you're on like an international sequence, you can go through customs like 2 times. Then when you go through customs, you have to go through security again. And then you're putting up your bag and you're taking on your bag and you're walking and you're up the escalator and you're going to get food and you're talking to passengers, you're pushing the cart and you're taking all the stuff, and it's a lot. You're gonna be tired. Remember, good, so I did tell you, but you can work around it. So now I realize, okay, don't pick up as many trips on my off days. All right, make sure that I get ample rest. I have to go to sleep. Make sure that I take my vitamins, be conscious of what I'm eating. Like I'm doing energy giving food, so I try to carry my own food a lot. I try not to eat like the oily, greasy food as much. I'm not gonna say, but not as much, to like make sure that my energy and stuff is like up there. So yes, well, you're gonna be tired. The next thing is you are going to work with a lot of different personalities. So what a lot of persons don't know is that flight attendants work by positions, and like on a regular plane, not one of the big ones, on a regular plane there are like 4 flight attendants. They are position 1, 2, 3, 4, and then every trip you can work a different position, and every trip you'll work with a different person. Some persons, when they get senior enough, they can work with their friends. Sometimes there is somebody I have flown with twice, and then yeah, but as long as I've been flying, every time it's a different crew. You might run into them into the airport after the trip and stuff like another time, but it's a different crew, and it's a different personalities. You're gonna have to learn to work around it. I've had experiences that I didn't love, but nothing like, oh, I'm gonna die, it's horrible. No, but I've had unpleasant experiences. Just not the best working style. You know, like we just never had that synergy that much. But that's something to note. Most persons, incredibly nice. Like, I'm on a trip now, and I'm on a layover now. And I mean, like, it's not the best sequence. It's early. It's, you know, it's not the best sequence. But the crew, like, it's a long time I haven't laughed so much. Those girls are hilarious. Like, I'm having such a good time. Like, we're gonna go out this evening by the lobby to have dinner, and I'm looking forward to it so much because they are hilarious. And you see, most times that's gonna be your experience. Like, fantastic. But no one then you're going to come across that co-worker where side eye, because why are you like that, ma'am? Me, I'm wearing like that. But you don't have to learn to work around it. So I would say anticipate the different personalities. So now I have grown in that regard. For say, you know what, if you're sweet, you're sweet, and if you're sour, you're sour. It's neither here nor there with the doll. Because I work, we come for work, and we don't come to jerk chicken. But before, like, where you thought everybody was gonna be sweet, and then I'm never sitting like, whoa, what's happening here? But now, I have no expectations. So if you're sweet, you're sweet, and if you're sour, you're sour. Either way, we're gonna work together. We're gonna have a great time. Plane not gonna land, and we're gonna go where we are. I'm probably not gonna see each other again. So Yeah, and that's my motto. Probably not gonna see each other again, so let's not. You don't have to make a big deal out of it. So, yes. So that's 2, 3. Took like a snap break. 3. You're gonna miss things. You're gonna miss things. As a new flight attendant, no, I'm not getting any weekends off. Like, you can't hold any weekends. So I'll be off like Monday to Thursday. But Friday, Saturday, Sunday, then I'll have to go to work, man. And most times, people in the regular world, it's crazy. People in the regular world, they have events on the weekends. And honestly, sometimes I've been able to work around it. Like, for example, my friend was having her baby shower the other day. I was able to do an early trip, come back and actually make it to the baby shower. It took a lot of planning and effort, but I was able to pull it off. But for example, my friend is getting married next month and I cannot make it. And I'm just so sad. Like, because you know, that's something she's been my friend for a long time. I've been looking forward to that, but I'm just not gonna be able to make it. My husband's birthday was on a Friday this month, and 2 weeks ago he wanted to go on a trip to Punta Cana. I took him to Punta Cana for his birthday, and I had to take him from Monday to Thursday, and his birthday was actual Friday. And when I came back Thursday, we have to just go work, my love. I have to go work. So I couldn't stay home with him and actually celebrate the actual day. But you know what? We had such a fantastic time. This job is gonna be as easy as you make it, or as hard as you make it, as fun as you make it, or as depressing as you make it. Or it's up to you. You're gonna be dealt this thing, and it's up to you to make it. This job is what you make it. So could I have moved around? Because we always spend our birthday together, the actual day together. That's a big thing for both of us. Could I have moved around and said, and I can't spend my birthday? No, because this job afforded me the privilege of carrying him to Punta Cana. Like, I flew this man out of the country. When we were flying back, we flew first class. Like, what we paid to go is nothing to even talk about. Big biscuit just in my hand too. There's nothing to talk about. And when I call him, sorry. I called him on Friday. I said, baby, how's your birthday going? He said, you know, I'm like, I'm fine. Because I felt like I celebrated it. And like, we're able to spend that kind of time together. If I were working a 9-to-5 just the same, I couldn't have done that. Last year, we got PF Chang's for his birthday. And was that horrible? No, it was not. But that's not how I like to fly my baby. Oh, I like to. Let's get on a plane. It was the joy of my life. Like, that didn't make me so happy. That still made me so happy to have given him a birthday of like that caliber, because he deserves it. Robert, I don't know where the rest are not gonna live, because make him the world, because he deserves it. So like last year, if I was working a 9-to-5, I could have spent the actual day with him, but would I probably have forgot the movies or one like a restaurant or something. I could not have, because a lot of times people don't fly because the tickets are so expensive. So if you can swing the hotel tickets, then you can get somewhere. And then, for example, a night in Miami is like $500, you know. We paid like a little over that. What we paid for 3 nights in Punta Cana I was shocked. I couldn't believe it. And when we went to the hotel, impeccable. A fantastic time. So no more power on the fact that I couldn't get the actual day. I was able to do something so special for him because of this job. So you have to remain positive. You have to remain you know, grateful, like exude gratitude. You see, me, if I'm the girl, and lots of people will have issues about this job, as I'm sharing these with you, I'm sharing them with you to open up your eyes, not for point out no flaw, because I'm having a good time is what I'm having. It's every day 10 out of 10. Every day is not 10 out of 10, but it's pretty close, so take that. And I know what it is to be in the real work world. I know what it is to work a 9 to 5. So now that I have this opportunity, like, I'm making the best of it. So we did what we could for his birthday, and when his birthday came, I said happy birthday, and I enjoy your trip, and we move on. I got to work so I can do something even bigger and better for him next time. So that's something to know. You will miss things, but you can make it up in other ways. You just have to think and expand your mind. Yeah, this one is a tough one. Has been a tough one for me. You have to be on. I almost feel like 24/7. Not 24/7, the time that you're on duty for. It's not a job. You can't sulky. You can't, at least if other people want to do it, that's a them. But I'm nothing more unattractive than a unpleasant flight attendant. You're a flight attendant. Put it together. Why are you smiling? You know? So, and you're gonna have your issues. You're gonna have your challenges. But someone said something to us when we were in the training process to become flight attendants. They said, when you're going to work, pack 2 suitcases. One with your stuff that you need for your trip. One with your problems. Put it under the bed. The one with your problems, put it under the bed. Take your one with the stuff and go to work. And when you come back, you deal with the one under the bed. Because even if you take your problems are still going to be there. They are not going anywhere. And that is so true. But it's easier said than done. And sometimes you might have to carry your problems. It will probably follow you go work. Sometimes into the terminal. But what I would say, like the other day, I was having a rough time. I was going through a period. And had a bad blowout. And at the time I got to work, I'm in a shambles, man. Me in a shambles, yet I think my mama dead. And it's alright. Like, Shan, we have to go get it together, girl. So, my friend talked to him, so I said, Shan, if we go get it together, cause we can't go up on the plane like this. Cause me keep it cute. You're never gonna see me sleeping on an aircraft. So, I'm gonna go to the bathroom, wash my face again. Take out my stuff, redo my makeup, fix my hair, take 2 deep breaths. I was at the airport early. I'm gonna buy myself one refresher at Starbucks. I'm gonna say, we're gonna fly the trip. If we're gonna break down again, break down when we reach the hotel tonight. But we're gonna fly the trip. And nobody on that plane could have told you that anything was wrong with me. Easier said than done, very hard. I was falling apart. And it's a job, like, people come on, hi, good morning, welcome, hi, good morning, welcome. And you have your co-workers and whatever. And you're falling apart, but you have to resilient. You have to strong. You have to resilient. And I had to do it. This was a Monday, and I flew through the Monday. Flew through the Tuesday, flew through the Wednesday, and I go back home and deal with what I had to deal with. But you're gonna have days like that. And I said, even if you follow you go to the airport and into the terminal, try leave it in one of the bathroom them. Don't bring it on the plane. And as I said, it's easier said than done. But it is just what the job calls for. The sulkiness, it's not the place. It is not the place. This biscuit tastes so good. The hotel where we are staying with the biscuit. Oh. chew good. So yeah, you're gonna have your issues, you're gonna have your days, but you have to stand firm and find that thing we're growing you. My thing is my relationship with Jesus Christ, my friends and my family. Probably for some people else, a music, probably, you know, like, in that moment, I had to say, God, you have to help me get through the sequence. I had to tell God, and God helped me to get through that sequence. And everybody have them different thing. I would have suggest God, but if you have a different thing, you have to pull upon that, but you have to be resilient in this job. Because you're going to go through things. And you have to show up. You have to show up. You have to show up. You have to be on, chirpy, perky. Coming like even when we get up at 3 in the morning. Yeah, I don't know. Job this for put on jeans pants, you know. Your face have to do. Yeah, at least if you take pride in your appearance and stuff. As I said, I keep it cute. So you're dressed like puss back foot, church like a morning. Like sometimes I put on my makeup and I'm like, it's 3:20. Heck? Like tomorrow morning, the pickup is at 4. So, the pickup is at 4. So I have to get up 3 o'clock. It is what it is. Certainly is what it is. So, we just have to do what we have to do, right? But this is not a job for the faint of heart. You have to be strong, you have to be resilient, you have to be tough. Yeah? Mm-hmm. And the final thing I want you to know before you become a flight attendant is, it's gonna be more amazing than you can ever think or even imagine. I've been flying going into my 5th month, and May 6th is gonna make 5 months, and I've gone to 19 countries. One of those countries I went before I started flying. It's the US. The US doesn't really count because I live in the US, but. And I went to Panama again. I went to Panama during college. But where do you hear of that? Who goes to 19 countries in 4 months? Where do you hear of that? A flight attendant. The hotels, like, you see the king bed? Some of these rooms, like, I remember we stayed in this hotel in Paris on the Champs-Élysées. The Champs-Élysées is something you learn about in school. What do you mean I'm staying at a hotel on the Champs-Élysées? Like the hotel was so nice, they gave robes and slippers. Like, yeah. I'm top tier. Like, so if your thing is going to hotel and them somebody, this is a job. This is a job for you. No, because I know, like, going to a hotel or sleeping in a hotel is like, at this point, I like my bed. Because I'm like, I'm so tired of seeing these white sheets. I'm never tired of sleeping in them, though. But, like, you know, like, it's amazing beyond your wildest imagination. The people you meet, the laughs you have, the experiences you share. This has eclipsed anything that I could have asked or thought or imagined. I'm so grateful to God. And you know, funny, somebody was asking me, like, was it like my childhood dream? And it was not my childhood dream. It could not have been my childhood dream. My first flight was at 18. That's when I took my first flight. Like, this was not a thing I was capable of imagining, like, traveling the world and literally what I have done. They sent me to Paris. I'll never get over the fact that I went to Paris. And I've done, like, so many, like, you know, like, for example, just because, like, I flew with Robert, as I said, to Punta Cana. That was his first That was his first. No, he has been to Bermuda, and then he lives in the States. So, and he has flown a lot. Robert used to fly a lot, my love. I mean it, but it's a good one. But like, that was like his first country. Like, you know, like Ireland. No, that was his first vacation. Like, we took together, like, as a couple. Like, I felt like such an adult, because I'm like, why are we out of the country by ourselves on our own? Like, that we paid for. That's crazy. And I mean, when we were coming back, like, we literally flew first class, which is like his first experience in first class. I was like, my heart like just expanded, because I'm like, that's such, it was his first birthday, so that was so beautiful. And like, just that I am in a job that affords him like that privilege, because he literally has the same flying privileges as me. His mom has flying privileges, my mom has flying privileges. Like, this, gonna get on a plane as long as your seat's available. Like, it's amazing beyond what you can comprehend. I still have not wrapped my mind around the fact that you can get on a plane and go anywhere in the world. Like, once you are off, you can go to the airport and go anywhere in the world. If there's seat on the plane, you can go. I cannot go back to work in a 9-to-5. I cannot. I do not know how much plane tickets cost anymore. It does not make any sense to me, because it's so amazing. And then you go to these amazing places. Like, I remember I had a layover in Salt Lake City, Utah, and I remember just the crew that we went to, fantastic. Had the best steak ever, and just had a good time. And like, these things, like, you cannot, no price tag, no price point. Like, my husband being able to go wherever he wants to go, my parents being able to go wherever they want to go, I being able to go where I want to go, and just the hopes, the possibilities. Like, I want you to know that becoming a flight attendant is gonna be one of the best things you ever do. And don't make anybody discourage you and tell you that it is being a glorified waitress, or, you know, passengers this, passengers that. Because even if it's being a glorified waitress, it's a glorified waitress with phenomenal benefits. Because, you know, this is the final time. Let's wrap up this video. I'm talking about something else. But I remember when I told someone, I said, you know, what I want to do next. I was working at an office. And I was like, I said to the person, I think I want to be a flight attendant. And the person was like, because I realized that I was more free spirited than I thought. Like, I don't want nobody put me on a desk. I don't want a boss. I don't want a manager. I don't want nobody call me. I don't want nobody come tell me them life story. I don't want to hear it. And that's the thing about being a flight attendant. You're so self-managed. That's the word. You're so self-managed, right? And I remember saying to the person, like, I want to be a flight attendant, and the person was like, oh, if you work a regular job and you make enough money, you know, you can fly wherever you want to go. Not true, because you get 10 vacation days, right? I took 4 days out of a month to take my husband to another country just because I wanted to. That's a part of my 12 days that I get off for the month. And if you don't want all your days off, then fly, and that's more money, that's overtime. Like, this is such a phenomenal opportunity. But that professes, that's why I left this point for last, because I want to make you know it's not perfect. You're going to have your challenges, you're gonna have your down days, you're going to have days. I've had days where like delays and stuff have been so long. I said, Jesus, please, I don't know what is me take upon myself. I've had issues. Minor issues with passengers, where I'm like, here comes someone, stay so. But eclipsed by the phenomenalness of this job. And I just want to say that I feel like, so this is my life's work. And if I stop being a flight attendant, I feel like it would still be something in the aviation industry. Because when those plane wheels lock up and we get up off the ground, I'm like, This is the one. So, those are the points I wanted to share with you. Hope you like this video. Share this video. Comment on this video. Tell me what else you want to know. Tell me what you want to see. Tell me what you want to know about being a flight attendant. And continue to like, share, subscribe. Follow me on TikTok. Follow me on Instagram. Follow me on Facebook. Probably the only Gen Z who use Facebook. And I love you guys. But Jesus loves you more. Never you ever forget that the Lord loves you. And I will see you guys in the next video from a certified fly girl. I love you guys. Bye.